Come back from the hell, good job, Blair. I mean, I was lucky, he's Queen Aces. Three. 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 Yes, there we go, final table. And we're all in here versus three big blind limp. Alright. Ah, four. Yes! Fine time in the big 11, guys. Boom! 94 bucks guaranteed. The main catch is not even 100 bucks. On the FT at least. I fired three bullets in this one. And I'm in the final table, fourth and chips. Looking good. Let's get the payouts ready. This is the right lobby. Nice. Alright, there's even more money up top than the big 33, but also way more runners. Let's get it. Thanks, man. 48k up here. Let's cash the 1-9 starter as well. It's possible to pay fewer without depositing. Yes, indeed. Really, really big free roll. Was Fischer like a check back here? Let's just. I think an ace will always call turn here, and everything else is anyhow folding. So, might as well bet here. Give it a shot. Greedy Lero, man, gets fully rewarded. It's good, man. 600k Lero on the FT. Not a bad one. I mean, we had like 350k after the East Queen hand. Just won many, many pots since. I like it. Wait, let me move this down a bit. Be in relaxed mode after all. Oh, yeah. Ooh, ladies. What up? Alright, good luck. This guy likes big opening raises, I know that. So this pot is pretty big already. Please no aces, kings, ace, king, Lero. So it's a pretty good board in general. Let's start with the bet. We should have so many A6 here. No! Yeah, we definitely want a bet flop there. Good pot though, 750k. Tweet it. So ein Big Lemon. He is from Germany. He's German, yeah. He is German. So we're down to 81 here, 47 paid. Next one in the making. I'm having fun again, guys. Know, when the results are coming, you're running good, it's fun. When not, then it's not so fun. That's the reason I usually choose to just run good. Doesn't seem like the best hand to bet, blocking 8s and 7s, some backdoor draws. Nice. Double barrel lateral. I want him to fold. I mean, not flat at least, but not through, but me. All right. Could still get awkward with Zodiac jams here. Clear check call is on the flop. Hopefully the turn is just the ace or eight of club spades. To make things a bit easier. That's also fine. Let's bet the turn here. Wanna protect my hand, get some value. River, we can check a quarter pot here. I think a quarter pot this. Actually, it goes slightly bigger. I just don't think he will check back many queen x on the flop. So he's just gonna have 7s so often. Ah. Tilt! Bad river. Bad river. I mean, you only bet a third, so it's fine. I know heavy jam 16 blinds with queen 7 off. And he makes a call on the river, guys. Big pot, 77,000 now. Get to fold up here as well. He called king queen. Nice stuff. Nice stuff. Run good Lero, man. Run good Lero. So out of line. Ace-10 suited was played reasonably, though. But I think it was also played reasonably on my end. Shouldn't really have too many, like, 10x to have in about two-thirds on the turn, you know? Actually, none. So if you lose, like, to 9s, maybe 10s, like, pocket 10s. Don't know. Ace-King is fine here. And before King-10. Rip. Me fold 4, sucker. Why is he so mean? I mean, he won like threes with ace queen and shit, like after losing his kings to ace four. Like, it's all right, dude. It's all right. Ooh, unlucky for the S10. No, oh, he says I'm on TV and false. Oh, Riverbanked. I think Riverbanked is a regular. That name sounds familiar. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe that was just a porno I watched yesterday. Who knows? I think on this tournament I can actually flat here. It was like a bigger stake FT. I think I have to play this 3-bet or fold, but on these lower stake final tables it's fine to flat. I'm open. Yeah, for sure. So let's see good flop here. Alright. That is interesting. Let's see turn. So you have a better hand than him. Not always, but most of the time. I still don't think I'm on a bet here. Ugh. Oh my god. The fuck. He had ace jack. Wow. I thought about raising the flop with ace queen. Probably should do it given that he has such an unreasonable range there. Ugh, I hate that we lose that hand. It's not a hand we should lose. Maybe we should bet turn. We might think it a bit longer about checking ace king. Yeah. Didn't expect the fish to call like fucking 6-5 off there. Yeah, because like if he has suited hands, he has like so few flush draws there. That like on the turn, flush draws. Not flushes, you know, because he doesn't have many offsuit hands, but with the range that he's playing, he definitely has a lot. And the betting becomes more appealing. I don't know. Mostly just an unlucky run, I would say. I'm not sure if I play this on a million anniversary. We'll see. Check down the river here. I think I get a call king 4 off. Hope he's bluffing often enough. That's very bad. It's one of these cracks that like have these weird raising ranges. I'm not sure if I'm a fan. I always want to make these calls and give people too much credit. I guess. There will be over here. That is queen pot was actually fairly big. 288,000, yeah. Yeah, not so sure. Like, it seems alright, obviously, like, to check the turn there. Just. Yeah, it's just not that amazing. We could raise flop, because he also only bets a third UTG. He might bet bigger with, like, sets or whatever. Like, just bet a third on the turn there or something with ace queen. Makes me probably lose a bigger pot in that scenario because I don't think he will fold 6-5, but generally I think it's slightly better. Let's check back to sixes here. Good turn. It's gonna be fun. I hope he bets like he checks. It's 5 2/3. Rip the missed flush draw here. Like 8 9. Maybe check jams pocket threes or some shit. I'm down. Still 4 out of 9 with my 30 BB here. Pretty short FT now. Average stack is just around my stack, so 32 BB average stack. Stack size seems fine. I don't know, we need to like get a top 3 finish here or something. Everything else is just like a joke. If you finish in like 7th base for like 190 bucks, finish in 9th of 1,000 runners, you know? 7th. Whatever, it's pretty brutal. So I think we start the FT with a similar stack to this one. Looks good for his queen. GG, Sanjay. GG. Ladder! We got to run a 33 now. Yes. Man, it's just one person busting, but this hole looks big. Let's fill it up a bit, you know? Maybe get him to chime, him to chime, him to chime. Random lead. Snap race. This guy likes to make his decision pretty damn quickly. Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 2. I never liked to play that game, but I always enjoyed watching my brother play it. So the good old days, man. I have to think of them a lot of like Ramon songs as well. Like Blitzkrieg Bomb or something. Cool. Good times, man. Good times. No answer. I literally already answered you. God. I literally linked you the HP link. I linked you. I gave you the answer in chat. Oh, please. But yeah, I usually don't answer questions of viewers. Just don't do it. It's not my type of streaming. Ridiculous low payout site. On the $11 investment. It's pretty sick if you think about it. Like 150x the first, like the buy-in. It's pretty absurd. There's some hope for the queen jack on that flop. But he doesn't get there. GG. Another letter. I said top three is what we at least need to finish here. Otherwise it's pretty bad. Otherwise I'm not happy. Like 190 bucks is just nothing. Like that's the buy-in for the 160 Pacific Rim, you know. But you know, everyone helps at least. Probably have to call here, right? Yeah. Alright, let's see what happens. Do we call or jam? I think he has enough bet folds here to just jam. Nice. Thanks for the great 3-bet sizing, mate. So I know, hey, wait, why would you call a 3-bet 6-9 offsuit? But then, like, when somebody gives you that 3-bet sizing, that 3-bet sizing right there, I just don't think we can fold. Like, that's... Yeah, it's like almost... Nice. 3 out of 7, good pot. It has way better payouts. Yeah, the payout structures in 88 are better than in PokerStars. Like in PokerStars, they pay out 20% now. But 88, they only pay out like really few people, like 12% or something. But obviously, these are like the little things Stars has been doing lately, right? Actually, what's the rake now for this? Yeah, look at this. It's. I guess that's also the reason like the payouts are low, right? Like because they take 27% more out of the prize pool now than what they used to. So, like in this prize pool, there's 200 bucks less than they used to in the past. It's actually quite a bit, holy shit. Yeah, it's 200 bucks. They save on the big 11 now per day. Or they make more. It's pretty sick. Thanks, Alphas. This is good to fold 99% of hands. Never. Like maybe in some satellites you want to fold everything but aces. When you get a good position on the last table, no, neither. I usually like to play an aggressive style. Also, it's tough to answer the question because it just depends on a couple of factors. Sometimes you want to be really aggressive, sometimes you want to be really tight. Depends. No answer, root Lero. Yeah. It's just OBS. I just window capture the PokerStars lobby and then just resize it using STRG and the mouse. All right, blinds go up, 35 bigs now. Better. We want a very bad here. This is wide range. Let's see what the turn brings. That's pretty interesting. would like an ace on the river. Given how he played the ace 10, I think it's really unlikely he has a flush here. He either has a board or nothing. So I'm gonna call river here. So I think he has nothing a bit more often. Sizing is most likely just to get called from a, like a king-jack type hand. Maybe something like 300? No, then we might as well jam. Come on! Let's fucking go, boys. What a turn. What a life. Chip leading the big 11. Whew. Well, very nice hand, he said. Thank you. Good turn. Lucky me once again. Nice. Actually, I thought about a hand like queens because he doesn't like to 3-bet much. So it's got to be a strong check, maybe, like a strong queens. King jack, you know. Nice, nice, nice. That was a good turn. Let's fucking go. Yo, thank you, Easy Fever. What up? I always say thanks. How you doing, man? I'm doing good. Got second in the big 33. Now we're chipping this one. And yeah, pretty exhausted. It's been an exhausting day. But a fun day. So we can close this one out. With the chip lead now. I guess with the chip lead. Nah. I'll get an Instagram story out. I will do that. Wow. This should be an easy call. Hopefully he's rejamming wide enough. Good luck. Nice. Always a sweat, man. Always a sweat. 14 off the money on the 109. Progress. Oh yeah, I want to do an Insta story. Sorry, HG sent me a message. So I was like, I was distracted for a second. Guys, we're on the final table of the big 11 now. Chip leading currently. First place, $1,556. Twitch.tv/Bolero, man. Almost 8,000 to stream. Let's go. Alright, let's go. What a hand. What a hand. Oh, fuck. Oh, call. Call. Blood and destruction because of one man. Because of one man. Ooh, he got ace queen in rough shape with him folding his check. GG, we're down to 6. I kind of like the payouts over the chat, to be honest. Let's raise call. Alright. Nice pot there, that was a big one. Don't slow play queens. I mean, he kind of fast played it. Just pre-flop. Just post-flop. Streamer always luck. Confirmed. Streamer always luck. Oh, great turn. Great turn. He's gonna have a lot of hands I wanna call here. Let's make it big. He's gonna call turn this so often. Sadly not this time. God damn it. Still a good pot though. Smooth FT so far. Yeah, I'm gonna give you guys the payouts for the 1-9 Sunday starter. Seems like we're about to cash. Dad? He called with pocket queens. Without a spade. We open deuces, big blind defense, clear c-bet. What's up with these min re-raise things? But I think we fold deuces. We would call ace-jack here, but deuces are just much worse to continue with. Let's keep on raising. Alright, I like my position here, man. This is an aggressive player. This is the final table constellation that I like. Thanks, Nova. Big own jams happening right now. Ooh, do you see a call here? I would call like, I mean, he's pretty tight. It's not a pre-spot with like ace-8. He's just sitting out now, I like that. Snap raises, man. It's better to call it, just click it back. I like clicking it back, honestly. Just has so many snap folds, so let's just deny him equity. No, you hammered a fresh bun at FTC. Yeah, it's just a habit of mine. Like to be up to date about everything, you know. Blue is usually recreational. Orange is a friend, and yellow is that I don't know yet. That might be that his shark soup is also block, or that I have a note on the guy. Just yeah. Sorry, not reviewing the hand right now. Sorry, I'm generally not reviewing hands from non-subscribers. Would just be too much, man. Whew, man, we're flopping pretty good right now. Good luck. We almost had him, guys. We almost had him. Holy shit. He was drawing thin, man. He was drawing thin. 9 or 4. Or ace. Damn, damn, damn. Would have been a nice half a million pickup there. Sick flop, by the way. Fuck, I need to stop singing. Every time I sing, somebody on YouTube complains. Sorry to the guys that watch this as a fine table replay on YouTube. Just can't help it sometimes. It's such a good song, though. We can listen to the many shades of black from the Raconteurs. I don't know how to say the name. I've read the name many times, but never actually said it. You and I were, it's been this way for long. All right, just stop. What? 2-5 versus 8-7? Wow, he checks the turn with the 8. He missed value there. 2x3 bet. Let's see a flop. Hopefully the flop includes the 10. The way we've been running on this FT, I wouldn't be surprised. Let's see. I guess the turn is the 10 then. I mean, the deuce 5 button open is like obviously totally out of line. Too many reads away when he might be watching the stream because it's pretty important. But he sees. And everyone agrees. Nice. Blinds go up again. I mean, it's fine. I usually prefer the deeper we are because, as you see, we are just crushing this tournament right now. Just gonna jam this for a bit under 20 blinds. Of black, so many lines of black. I think this guy is like just a bit over the whole thing. I'll check back and bluff some turns or rivers. Or just give up. I think that's alright, given the speedy call, how tight he has been in the past, and the ball texture really, really not favoring me. And tips on how to play $500, $1 buy-in turbo tournament. What? $1 buy-in turbo tournament? I don't know. I guess, look, if you have no idea what to do, then just check, look for a push fold chart online and follow that advice there. Seems like the best bet. But yeah, be tight around the bubble. Be tight if there's stacks that are shorter than you when you make the final table. Those are the basics. This guy's kind of weird. Sometimes he just tanks. Like, he also tanks before opening for quite some time. So it feels like pulling out a chart. Okay, where do I have my big blind defending chart again? Okay, great. Wait, folder, pictures. Should I take the upswing ranges or should I take the ranges a friend sent me? Oh, okay, I should defend. All right, I found it. All right. Good flop, small bet. And turn will be a deuce, then I will overbet, and then we'll have some fun. It's okay. Actually, I will just go big. Too bad. 1.72 million. Man, I wasn't even bluffing that much yet. This guy 3x, I defended. We 5 the money, so let's be careful. The river's a queen to make things a bit easier for me. Alright, let's just give up, dude. Just give up. Nice. Wouldn't be happy if defies the third barrel there. Ace 5 off. Let's go. Good pot. Defend the big blind here. This is open. It's just sizing. There's no need to call a king high like that. Sick, like 20 blinds, 20 blinds, 20 blinds, 40 blinds, 40 blinds, big stack. Let's play accordingly. Alright, that makes it easy. Yeah, to be honest, I would have probably folded versus him in the end. Well, he opened 5 the money, I said to get in with 6s. Depends on what he opens. Nice. Went for a little bit of an out of line open again, but I think it's fine how the tournament went so far, even though he probably gets in quite wide. But we ahead. That looks good. No 9. No 9. Rip. Alright, let's get the payouts on the main screen now. With the queens in the mix. No action now. Actually, I will leave them over the chat. I think the payouts over the chat look just really good, actually. Look at that. I think that looks pretty nice. Looks much better than usual. So if we didn't knock him out there with our check deuce versus ace 4, that would have been a good spot. Bolero's literally on the fine tables every time I come in. Name change to Bolero. Yeah, thanks, man. Let's just do a half exit. I guess betting is still fine. We fold out like a lot of ace highs, 7-8, 7-9, those type of hands. Obviously, we can follow up on some turns as well. Yeah, the stack size are quite interesting for them right now. Like, those guys are so even and he's so short, so we might be able to put some additional pressure on. The question is, like, do they even understand what ICM is? Because I think there's only recreationals left, which is nice. By big with the A7 off. Well, I think on the turn, he usually has hands that want to call or hands that want to fold. So let's make it big in case he folds. Because like if I bet small, he's still gonna fold like the hands that he will fold anyhow, you know? I didn't see Molly's game. Be nice if this guy just plays a bit quicker. Oh, by the way, I forgot to cheer on. I'm not gonna do it now. Fuck, he busted him. He won a big pot. Fuck. Should have cheered, but too late. No. Would be cool if you make it headside, man. I kind of like this guy. I've met like so many Dutchies that have like this type of attitude and this type of humor, and I love it. Obviously not falling to the sizing. It's a good flop. Not sure why he does this like 2x3 betting all the time. We have a double gut shot, but the other side is really bad, so we just fold here. Alright. Let's take this down. I mean, this guy will get punished at some point when he goes for these small 3-bets. He dodged the first 2 times, though. Alright, next goal is get to 2 million. I want 2 million chip stack. Yes, thanks for the guys to follow button on break, by the way. Let's keep rolling. Guess calling is better than jamming? Question mark? This guy doesn't have 100% c-bets. How bad can a jam be, really? It's better third. Should see a bunch of folds here. Could have jammed pre-flop as well. At some point, it had to stop working, what I did there. How do you rate your heads-up skills? Do you think you need to improve? I think my heads-up skills are, like, good enough. Definitely need to improve, though. One nice pot here with fives versus some other hands. King 8 suited, he opened, he flat ace 5 and we check down. It's a pot developing down here. I'm just making a deal. Like, if they want to pay me like a little bit less in first place, then I'm down. Are we knocking someone out before the money? I guess we just go for it. I mean, if he has these king screens, oh, so disgusting. Bleh. For 40 blinds, nah, it's just not happening. Pretty sick. For 40 blinds, checks into aces blind versus blind. I don't know. Like, when he goes for 2x3 bet, yes, we could. But I don't really see it. Pretty filthy. But this is like how fish make deep runs, for example. These kind of setups. Yeah, that close to money. Maybe we can find a fold. I don't know. The thing is, like, I can't really see the fold to the 3-bet. You know, I don't see how I do that. So what I could do is not 4-bet. And I don't think we can fold to the 5-bet, given the amount of chips we invest already. Wow. Wow! Kings versus queens on the FT, and there's a queen. Sick. Sick. Nah, I don't think I can play Winamax from the UK. Nice, Berserker, geil. Weiter so, man. Kratz. Yeah, that spot sucks with checks. not a happy spot. But I think 4-bet we have to. Yeah, it doesn't seem terrible. Sick that he sucks out there. I would rather let him win the hand. He's a bit tricky. But also, he likes min raising. Gives us the walk, though. Can we continue raising? Then anything I have on you. Thank you. I get through. So I need to get the 1-9 startup just to stay up to date with how stacks are developing on other tables. I just don't see how he jams it better every... Like, he might jam pocket 8s and pocket 9s, but then he jams 2 6s like that, so I think we ISO. I would definitely ISO pocket 8s here always. Pocket 6s, fucking hate it. 7s, I think we have to. Such a random open jam. Sklub! Thank you. This guy ran fucking terrible. Like, he ran fucking terrible on the FT. I think my ISO is correct though. Like, we can't expect a guy to open jam checks there, right? Like, I just don't see how we can put that into his range there without any more information. But I think, like, the hands we've seen from him don't make me believe that he nice, he has garbage and we have quads, that's cool. Yeah, just the hands we've seen him do play. I don't think we can go for a read like that he would have it like that. So we can cooler him. Wow. I mean, this tournament is fairly easy, I would say. Pretty sick. Good life we're living. Holy shit, we ran good on this fine table so far. He calls the flop bad, let's bet turn as well. All right. Bad beats happen, he says. TY. Funny dude. Bad call ICM. You still don't know what ICM is. Well, would you say ICM because his jamming range would be tighter? Can you play through on two different sizes? I said illegal. I think that's illegal. I don't know. I don't know the rules. 100 chips, you should just call this min 3-bet. Like, you could just be bluffing there without any further information. It's a 3-bet call here. Can't fold checks. Is he still getting it in here with 10s or 9s? Alright. What a sick run on this final table. Like, holy shit. What an absolute god run on this final table, man. Holy fucking shit. Like, what? That is like, what the fuck? How does someone run that good on the final table? Absolutely unreal to run that incredibly hard on the final table. I can't even, man. How the fuck do you run like that? Unbelievable. Unbelievable. That was such a sick hour of power in the last 3 minutes. What the fuck? Right now, the hand is on stream. We'll win with the sevens versus checks. And now I have 4 million in the heads up. That is like the most absurd run I've ever had on the final table. For sure. For sure. Like, absolutely unreal. Wow, set over here. It's going to be a 3-bet call. Let's win the heads up this time. I'm just flop sizing twice. Makes it clear that he's a recreational. Block bet or check are both fine. I like to check more. Nice. Don't think we can call to that sizing. Fold to that sizing. Couldn't that all be spades? I run the worst. The fuck is this run? Yeah, that was unreal. What a scam. Yeah, pretty absurd, I have to say. Like, I'm a bit surprised myself. What the fuck are these 3-bets, dude? Like, how do you afford anything? Why are these that many small 3-bets on this fine table? So weird. Sure, take it. Kind of want to 3-bet this. Actually, we're 37 big blinds deep. We're too deep to 3-bet. Absolute garbage. The star. We checks back one. It's pretty unusual. What the fuck, Hita? That is like absolutely ridiculous what we just went through there. That is the most ridiculous run on the fine table like I've ever seen or done myself. Like, what the fuck? Interesting turn. Let's hit one of our outs. That's an out. Alright, he probably doesn't check a 9, so let's value bet here. Nice, come on, boys. He had 7-10 and makes the call. They just don't respect me, man. Nice. Good check, Henry. It's really important that we can keep him small as well. Like, if you double him, it kind of sucks because then things could get dangerous. He doesn't like firing bullets, so I'm gonna call. Easy call on the turn, obviously, but not excited. Like, what the fuck, man? The amount of merged betting going on in all of my games that I've been playing recently is too damn high. It's just too damn high. Like, on the flop bet, okay. I mean, I guess turn bet can't be that bad. Alright, never mind. That's actually okay. Alright. Confession to make. Pretty dry board. Let's see if it's more. Bad turn. Let's check. Great river. Ugh. For real? Do you really think you would ever pick the side thing with like ace 2, ace 4? I think that's a really, really good laydown. I think it's the correct decision, but it doesn't make me happy. Here in the stone bubble, let's call here. Sum up all the other tables. Alright, never mind. We can just fold. Bet's turn, I fold. Obviously, ace would have won the whole thing. Why would he jam that on the bubble, lol? That's a pretty bad jam by him. He probably plays too many tables. We win the money now on the 1-9 starter, that's cool. Oh, that ace 8 fold. It makes me happy though. Like, I know these spots. You just call and you're always behind. It's not good. Right. I didn't think it was to call it, like, better unpaired ace, so I think like queen check seems like a reasonable call because I think it would size up at the flush. Yeah, thought about it, all right. What the fuck is this limp now? Just throws in a limp 60 blinds deep for the memes. All right, we cashed the starter, nice. So it's like $220 min cash or something, pretty good. $211 min cash. Move down to where they don't respect your raises. Just sick in which spots I got hero call today. I would lead a bunch of 5x. I think king 5 plays fine as a check. Call. It's a good river. You should probably check it back pretty often here. Okay. Yeah, we should just attack his limbs. A lot in the money and instantly get a jamming hand. Nice life. He's gonna have plenty of weak aces still, so not to worry. Nothing to worry about, and we hold. Good. But that wasn't a merge, it was a value bet. Doesn't make much sense what he said, right? It was somewhat of a mergey bet, but I think it's actually a fine one there. Maybe I should start raising more with these type of hands. Such a good call for information, I think. Like, what the fuck is the... What the fuck? Like, what the fuck is that? Like, I'm getting tilted, man. This is ridiculous, these bets. One thing I got to call a 3-bet. The sizing is just a small to fold anything. It's a pretty good board. Let's start with a bet. And I'm going to bet turn as well. Just going to fold out all the ace highs you can have. Nice. Like, he... It's just so... Why would you check back the turn just to bet the river then? But good information, I guess. Good information. It's a good hand for us with the queen six. You know, we finally punished him for his small 3-bets. So let's call again. I don't mind these too much, honestly. Like, I can just call and see a flop. You know? Yeah, we can 3-bet his hand just for value. It's just gonna call with a lot of hands that we dominate. Alright, let's have some fun. It's a bit of a bigger 3-bet. I think it's fine to fold King 6 off versus that. So funny. I didn't even know what to 4-bet against that for bluffs because I can just call everything and see flop. Let's tank a bit and check it back. I think that gives me some more credible turn bluffs. Pretty big sizing, usually a bit smaller. What is the fucking point here of these 3-bets, man? Ugh, poor river. Should I call? I mean, I'd be afraid of ace queen, but he still has ace 5, ace deuce. Yeah, queen check, he just check calls. Like, this guy is so random and just doesn't bluff. It's so sick. Like, this play is just so... What's the fucking point of check calling queen check there, you know? Like, what the fuck? I'm just gonna bet here. Like, he raises all of his asex, so. I mean, he's so weird, like... I should never call, but, like, we get a lot of information again, so that's something, okay? Let's focus on the information we're getting. It's fucking ridiculous, honestly, that he, like, just casually checks call, like, the min 3-bet into the check call, into, like, everything is just so ridiculous. But I should be better than calling river there. He just always has it. I guess we call the turn here. Okay, checks now. I'm just not sure what he delayed bets there, you know? Let's call. And half pot bet. There we go. Don't think raising would be horrible with that hand. Oh, so sick. Maybe I should have raised the flop. But, you know, we have a good idea about him now. I know strip counts are even, but I'm pretty sure where I'm at. Let's hope he continues to follow the same strategy throughout the rest of this. I I just want to race it for protection, honestly. I should, yeah, I'm gonna race more for protection. I think it's pretty important against him. Like, he literally just fires everything, so getting these flop forwards is pretty nice. Alright, maybe we can just get an 80 blinds here versus checks. Nope. Open King Jack off UTG, we got clicked. Let's see a flop. Right, he's probably gonna win this one. Let's see a flop. Ooh, he c-bets. Does it mean he doesn't have it? We'll see. Alright, let's play for stacks here. What? Oh, guys, if he checks the flush on the turn there, good for him. If I call here, pot is like 2 million. Are we calling or are we jamming? I guess we're jamming. Okay. Wow, pretty sick. Pretty sick, that was a random heads up match. Feels pretty bad to lose it, to be honest. I don't think we can do much. I mean, it's literally just the worst turn in the deck in that hand. Like, I'm not happy once he raises it like that, but he can have like ace king with a spade, king queen with a spade. So I don't really think we have that much of an option with top two here. Not happy about it, obviously, but yeah. Sucks that we lose two heads-up matches in one day. The spot I don't like that we played is actually not that many. Like, I should have raised twice for protection. And pretty sure that that was, like, a side misplay. And then we also, like, fucked it up a bit with, like, the king-4 call there. Pretty sick.